for me is it's normally, see, cheese is normally in the house ready for Christmas Day, late evening or Boxing Day, but that's always the first port of call. Christmas Eve, midnight snack, get on the cheese. Dead easy. Wok, fry them in a, like a proper Chinese wok with some chestnuts, some bacon and a little bit of sesame oil. Comes out perfect every time. Steamed, so they steam in their own kind of juices. Really quick to do, really easy. Don't overcook them. They've still got a bit of crunch on them. Tastes lush. Everybody normally parboils them, then drains the water and shakes them in a pan with the lid on. Stop doing that. What you need to do is gently poach them in softly simmering water and then lift them once they're cooked all the way through. So the potatoes are cooked just like you do, just normal boiled potatoes, but don't boil them so they fall apart. And then lift them out and leave them to cool on a cake rack for about 20 minutes. And what happens is they dry up on the outside and they start to get a little dry crust and they crack. And then put them into a hot roasting tray that's already in the oven with oil in, and that you kind of fry them. Don't cram them into the tray too much either, because that creates steam. So lots of little spaces between them, roast them up like that, and then they'll go crispy every single time. And you haven't got to worry about when they'll be cooked, because they are already cooked because you've blanched them first or you've boiled them first. So you're just frying them on the outside and getting them nice and crispy. I like a load of condiments. So I like cranberry jelly. I like bread sauce. I like onion sauce. I like mustards. I like all those sort of things. As many of those sort of condiments that you could have as possible that get spread all over. It goes beautiful. Cranberry sauce goes wonderful with roast potatoes. Mustard on turkey goes really well if you're going to have roast beef. There's so many things it goes with. So a load of condiments. Stock the fridge up or the cupboard up with loads of stuff in jars. It sounds a weird one, but I'm a massive fan of pickled green chilies. Now, those green chilies, instead of them being, you haven't got a man, you know, like the ones you get from a kebab shop? They haven't got like that, but chopped up finely, put through, just spread a little bit through some cabbage, through carrots, through Brussels sprouts. They're amazing. They just give a slight little tinge of heat and add flavour to everything. Grated orange. Now, it's not orange juice, like the zest of an orange. If you grate that on a fine grater on loads of different stuff, it gives it a real Christmas feel. And what you're doing when you're grating the orange is you're releasing oils. So it gives it like a, just that kind of wonderful Christmas smell and taste onto so many things. It goes really well with meat. Again, it goes really well with the vegetables, particularly carrots, goes really nicely. So grated orange on loads of stuff at Christmas works ace. Again, heading back to orange, alternative Christmas pudding. So if you actually cook oranges whole and boil them as an orange, cover them in water and cook them until they go really, really soft, I have got a recipe somewhere out there on a website or in one of my books where those cooked oranges get blended with some polenta and some flour and eggs, and they get baked and you get this wonderful kind of like orange cake, which is absolutely delicious. You haven't got to have Christmas pudding, but it still tastes of Christmas. Always a full English. You cannot avoid a full English on Boxing Day because most people have a stonking hangover. There is no better cure for a hangover than black pudding. There's so many Christmas nibbles out there, so many things that range from and all sorts of crisps and snacks. But for me, it's a childhood memory, and I love walnuts. So it's kind of like the only time of the year that you can imagine stood there with a nutcracker cracking walnuts. It just fits the Christmas. A log fire cracking walnuts, amazing. It's hard to avoid how brilliant Jamie Oliver is, because his enthusiasm, his ability to get people cooking, and he clearly loves what he's doing. And the idea of cooking for family and friends is everything that Jamie's about. So, you know, if there's a Christmas Jamie Oliver special, I'm all over that. Let me think. Oh yeah, I'm having a baby. Oh. That's it.